You know, it would really break me. It would destroy my psyche. If I lived, I died, and never actualized anything on this earth, never made an impact on this globe, never put into motion what I was born to do. You will never change what you ignore or tolerate. Whatever you don't hate, you tolerate, man. And that will eventually exacerbate. What are you exacerbating today? And that is sad because we were meant to make an impact on this globe, this planet, this plane. If you think you can't, then you will not. Listen, you are no better than the thoughts you think. Do you have the courage to think things through? Because if you don't, you will never ever attain that which you seek after so desperately. In your mind, your body, and your soul, everyone was placed on this planet to make an impact, to take that seed of desire and to allow it to germinate, to spring forth, all resulting in positive fruit. Fruit that not only affects you, but affects others around you. We are only stunted by the perception that we have of ourselves. If you perceive that you cannot, then, hey, you will not. You see, one of the most powerful things you can change about yourself is your belief. It is learning to come to terms with who you are meant to be. Ask any child, Jimmy, who do you want to become? And Jimmy says, well, I want to become a fireman, a pilot, a doctor, or you know what, maybe even a race car driver. But has anyone realize how convicted Jimmy is? That's manifestation. It's the germination of words. And that which he has spoken more often than not will become. We are the centurions to the future of our children. I want us to remember that. Never forget that. And the awesome thing about this, folks, is that he believes it. He knows it's going to come true. Oh, but be very aware of how easy it is to become that child's dream killer. One of the most sad things in life is to know that you've become an adult and not have the memory of those formative years of self-expression. That really is sad. Then you ask, who is to blame? Now, you're supposed to be seen and not heard, okay? And Jimmy says, yes, please, okay. And I'll tell you to all those dream killers, look at what you've done. It makes him not believe anymore, or it diminishes his thought process of becoming who he said he wanted to become when he was 5 years old. Is Jimmy still buried inside of you? How on earth can we maintain our sanity without creativity? I mean, we work 9 to 5, we take the children to school, take them to classes, swimming lessons, to football, but we never really become whole inside. There's this emptiness, this vacuum, this nondescript, depressive mode. It's a set button, and it's on autoplay. Every single day of your life, you get up, you wander around, basically, and you're never ever confident in your way of dealing with people because you don't really know who you are. At some points, yes, you feel confident, but whenever there is something that deflates you. You may have had a bad day, you may have had a bad meeting, maybe your children were a bit naughty, and it sends you spiraling into that vacuum again and regretting everything you have done thus far. And this longing and clinging and yearning, which is deep buried inside of you, says, I never really fulfilled who I was meant to be. You know, people are not looking for you. They really are not looking for you. That's the honest truth, because they are looking for your ideas. They don't care about you. They care about your ideas. And if you don't manifest what you are carrying inside, this world will never, ever acknowledge you. And yes, it will ignore you. And the only evidence that you would have been on this planet Earth is the evidence of your headstone in the cemetery. Is that who you want to be? Of course not. Then we need to make changes as if our lives depended on it. We need to come up with a plan. Yes, there is a problem, even if you are the problem. But how do you have that solution? How do you find that solution that is tailor-made for you? And the only plausible way is to fail. To fail, yes, again and again. Failure is a friend. Don't ever allow failure to put fear into you. Do you think you have the courage to think things through? Your circumstances are not the problem, your thoughts are. I remember when I was about 9, 10, and I saw for the first time in my life somebody juggling a football, a soccer ball. And then the guy who was juggling, he turned from a soccer ball to a tennis ball, and this gentleman was juggling at least, I counted 100. And that was such a mind-altering experience because now I wanted to do that. I wanted to be the person doing that. And I asked him, "Sir, could you explain exactly what you were doing and how did you do that? How did you manage to do that with your feet? Come on, that was incredible." And this is what he said to me. He said, "I'm not going to give you the explanation because I'm not quite sure you're able to understand. I do, however, think you're capable of experiencing this. So here's what I'll do. I'm going to give you this tennis ball. And when you juggle to 100, come back to me and I'll show you more." So, excitedly, I took the ball home, spoke to my mom and dad, and I said, "This is what the coach gave me, and this is what I have to do. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but somehow, some way, I am going to do this because this is awesome, no matter how long it takes. Please?" I mean, I was still a kid. I had to get their permission. Now, he gave this to me, and he said, "If you can do this, if you can juggle to 100, I'll coach you. I'll show you everything I know." Needless to say, it took me almost a year to do that. Yes, indeed, blood, sweat, and tears. Juggling every single day with a tennis ball from morning to evening, I would hide away from my parents to try to accomplish this seemingly impossible task. Now, I had no football shoes, no special equipment. We had no money really to invest in that, although I would have loved it. But boy, it really did show me how to appreciate the simpler things in life. I took cardboard from somewhere around the house. I tore it and pieced it together, put it at the top of my shoes just to fortify the top because it was becoming a bit soft now after so many weeks of attempting to try to get to 10. Because you see, the aim was to spin the ball, to spin it back to me so that I could have the ultimate control and that my head was supposed to be positioned over the process. I was supposed to be looking down, my head over the ball, over my feet, and then position my feet with my toes pointing upwards. Well, all in all, after doing that for almost a year, having my blood, sweat, and tears on that basement floor, now this gave me a new perspective, a new appreciation. I was so proud of myself. I mean, it went from being able to do 100, 200, and then ultimately 500. But that set the stage, and that was a springboard for excellence, and that set the discipline. It also achieved the goal. But the goal is never, ever completed. There is always a goal. There is always a mission. And whatever that mission is, I pray that it is not an easy mission. You need those battle scars. Seize that day. Seize those opportunities. You are one mindset away from living your dream. Who's going to stop you? Who's going to prevent you? Only you can prevent you. Listen, circumstances may dictate that you go around a situation, under, even over. But ultimately, you are the person sabotaging your own success. Yes, ultimately, you are your worst enemy. If you really want to make an impact on someone, let them speak first. That's a strategy. If you know just a little bit about them and what they want, then that will give you the information. Yes, it will give you the info to ask the right questions, to make you interesting to them. I'll say this again. If you think you can't, then obviously you cannot. You are no better than the thoughts you think. Come on, guard that one thing that is most important to you, and that is your creative process. What is going on for you? What are you working on? What's your vision? What's your passion? What's that thing, that one thing you go to bed thinking about or get up on mornings just exhilarated and excited to even think about the process again? What is your passion? Your passion is you. Your passion, your ideas, your being, it is you. You are the one who markets you. You are your skill set. You are your success. You are that walking billboard which says, "I am an idea. I am a skill set. I am my new normal."